Look and feel younger, too.
Behind the headlines, her husband peddled human flesh. Next, Oprah.
Today on Daytime, Dave gets some pampering.
This is definitely not my father's barbershop.
Easy workout tips.
Oh, come on.
What?
And an update on a four-legged friend.
Well, just
look at that.
There you go.
There you go. I'm Cindy Edwards.
I'm Dave Nemeth. Thanks for joining us here today on the show. What you got?
I have something for you.
Make the most of it.
A few months ago, we introduced you to a lovely little pooch called Karma. Adopted from an animal shelter, the owner quickly learned that the pup had some trouble with its front paws. On our earlier show, we showed you how Karma had to get around on his hind feet. Well, since then, Karma has undergone surgery to repair his front paws. Now Karma, his owner Don Ladd, and Dr. Colm Hay, who performed the surgery, are here to give us an update. Welcome back to you, Don, and welcome, Dr. Hay.
Thank you.
And welcome back, Karma, too. So the surgery happened, and Dr. Hay, I'll start with you. Mm-hmm. How extensive were Karma's injuries, first of all? What did you have to do?
Well, what he had done is he'd broken both of his wrists above, both bones above the wrist. Mm-hmm. And the technical name is the radius and the ulna. So in you or me, it would be like right here. And it had healed at an abnormal angle at 90 degrees. So we had to go in and break down the old healing and straighten it.
Sounds like a pretty extensive surgery. Did it take
was.
A long time?
It took a while. It took about 40 minutes for the first side, which was the left side, uh-huh. and about an hour for the second side, which is the right. The right was definitely more of a challenge than the left was.
You had to put something in Karma's mm-hmm. arms?
Yeah.
Show us
what
little, you got there.
We put little stainless plates. I mean, this is not the... the plate that was put in there, the plates that are in there are much, much smaller, but pretty much these are made out of orthopedic grade hardware, which is usually stainless steel to put in there. Sometimes people put titanium in, but we use stainless steel mostly.
Is this a common problem for little dogs that they end up, maybe they,
yes.
they've jumped down from something and they break
yes.
the this
two is
front
a,
paws?
It is a very, very common problem
oh.
Because dogs his size are living in an environment with large beings, i.e. us,
right.
and even being carried at waist or shoulder height is a far enough drop for them when they hit the floor to break these bones.
Oh, it's so sad.
The most common fracture I see.
So Don, how's Karma been doing since the surgery?
Well, he's doing fabulous, and he's getting around, motoring about very quickly as usual. Trying to go down on the legs, it's going to take some time. He's got to build some strength in them, but he's definitely interested in trying that. And giving it a shot every couple steps, really. So we're real pleased so far.
He's still more comfortable walking on his hind legs, isn't
yes.
he? It's
yes.
going to take some time. Does
mm-hmm. He's going to have to learn.
Is there physiotherapy involved after an operation like this on a dog?
Yeah, what we did is we bandaged the legs to protect the repair
yeah.
because his bones are so small and the hardware that's in there is so small, he could break it. And in fact, we had to revise the right-hand side a few weeks later because of the screws pulling out. So we had to protect him with splints. And then after he comes out of the splints, which he's just done, we're going to start some more physical therapy to try and strengthen the tissues so that he doesn't drop down on his wrists as much as he's doing.
Right. See, you can almost kind of see how he's still sort of like that. So we want to get him up on the pads of his little paws, right?
Yes. That's the goal.
So he's going to be doing a little bit of swimming to help get some
swimming?
Strength. Yes, he has a little life vest, and he'll be swimming in the bathtub for a while to try to help build some strength in those arms. And I think he's going to do just great. We're very excited.
Obviously, he's looking good. Let's put him down, see what happens. Let's just see.
Okay,
you say that depending on the surface, he will put his paws down, but still right now, he's like a circus dog. He just likes to be on his hind legs. He loves mommy. He doesn't like to be away from Don for too long. Can you walk on all those legs?
Well,
yes, look at that.
There you go.
There you go.
And I mean, that you just can't mm-hmm. really understand. Before, he would have had to go down mm-hmm. on his forearm, and he had sort of created very large calluses on both arms, like an extra elbow, and they were very large, and as you can see, they're gone.
It looks great. So, he looks wonderful, and so glad that the surgery was a success, and interesting to know that this is something that a lot of dogs, unfortunately, have to get done, but there is hope.
Definitely.
There you go. All right, Don, Dr. Hay, and Karma, thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Give a paw. There you go. We'll be right back with more Daytime. Stick around. A new study, Hair Today.